What's up, everyone, and welcome to this month's edition of Ice 3. I am your host, Long Island Ice Z, Zack Ryder. And look, Mom, I'm not wearing my sunglasses. Anyway, throughout the month, WWE Classics on Demand is giving you the best from the guys who deserve a little recognition, the guys whose contributions to sports entertainment have gone under the radar, the strong, the determined, the unsung heroes. Truth be told, without stars like these, we would not have some of the mega superstars we have today. Let's take a look at my first pick, which features one of the unsung heroes. No, it isn't me. Although, I definitely would consider myself an unsung hero of the modern era.
Scorpio trying to intimidate Malenko, playing a psychological game. He's got the wrong man. Referee checking both the shooter and Scorpio. I don't think it's Scorpio's nature to smuggle a foreign object in the ring, and I don't believe the shooter needs one to hurt somebody. And we have seen that in the past.
They're coming into the ring by his manager, the sexiest man on earth.
Oh, I forgot about him. That may have been the longest ring introduction we have ever had here in the ECW, and it just goes to prove what a long list of credentials has the shooter, Dean Malenko. There's the bell, the title is on the line. Too Cold returning to Extreme Championship Wrestling after suffering an injury at the hands of Batman, the shooter, Dean Malenko. Upon his return to ECW, Scorpio's been on a roll, defeating Hector Guerrero of the world-famous Guerrero family. But last night, he suffered an ankle injury, one, which may hamper his efforts tonight to wrest the Extreme Championship Wrestling Television Title from Malenko. Go behind by the shooter. Armringer by Scorpio, nice escape. Malenko looking for a way out. And does, reverses the hold.
The Major League Baseball players ended their 232-day strike in 1995. Man, I don't know how they were allowed back in the Major League with all those strikes. I thought it was supposed to be three and you're out.
Scorpio now holding on to Malenko. Malenko escapes. Both champion and challenger circling one another. Scorpio favoring that injured ankle. Malenko goes downstairs with a knee and lands an elbow. Face first in the top turnbuckle goes Scorpio. Batman takes over Scorpio. And the flat of the boot right to the face, that is legal. And this time to the back of the neck. Scorpio rolls up, one, two, and up. Scorpio downstairs with the right hand now. Straight right to the jaw, nothing fancy about that. Malenko shaking out the cobwebs on the outside. Jason coming over to discuss strategy with the shooter. Shooter seems to be in his own world, though. He's so focused, he is so intense. Frustrated, He's definitely hot. He's back in the ring. Collar and elbow tie up. Go behind by Malenko. Scorpio lands an elbow. Straight overhand right by Scorpio. Make it two. Rabbit punch to the back of the neck. Malenko shot in. Face first. Malenko is dropped by Scorpio. And now Scorpio on the offense. Scooping a slam. Scorpio going up. Leg drop. Cover. One, two, and no. Two and a half. Half the count away from crowning a new television champion. Scorpio now trying to wear down the shooter. Immediately rolls off his back, great wrestling instinct to get his shoulders off of the mat. And Malenko slides underneath the bottom rope, but Scorpio goes right out with him. He is tenaciously holding on and lifting at the same time. Malenko rolls back in, Scorpio right with him, refusing to relinquish the hold. The shooter, if he wants to give it up, no way. Malenko goes downstairs with an elbow. Make it two off the ropes. Scorpio ducks down off the near side. Comes Malenko. Drop kick by Malenko. Scorpio went to the well, once two up, and tried to drop the shooter face first once again. But that drop kick took quite a bit out of Malenko as well, as he came crashing down hard. Both men back to their feet. A fist and a headbutt by Malenko. Cover, one, two, and no. The shooter now stalking the challenger. Scorpio rolls to the outside, creating a timeout. Malenko, giving him no breathing room, goes right out after him. Oh, Scorpio, Malenko back in. Malenko grabs hold of that ankle. And down on the ankle and the knee. Like a piranha that smells blood, like a bird of prey, you can bet the shooter will be relentless in his attack. On the injured leg of the challenger, Scorpio. Scorpio manages to roll out of the way. Malenko did not hit flush with that knee. But that one was a direct hit. Malenko rolls to the outside. Scorpio trying to hold on. But Malenko smashes the knee into the ring post. Jason roaming the ringside area. Smirk on his face right now as the shooter has matters well in hand, as well as Scorpio's leg. Referee Jim Mahler asking Scorpio if he wants to give it up. No way, says Scorpio. Malenko locks on a submission maneuver. Scorpio refusing to give it up, holding on to Malenko's arm. Desperately fighting for leverage. And Scorpio makes his way to the bottom rope. Malenko will have to break the hold. The shooter continues to attack the lower leg of Scorpio. And at this point, it's becoming more and more obvious that Malenko could win this matchup whenever he chooses, at any juncture. At some point, you have to think Scorpio, for his own good, for the welfare of his own wrestling career, will have to give it up. Perhaps the referee should seriously consider stopping this matchup. As the shooter is having his way with Scorpio, who doesn't stand a chance against the television champion. Scorpio tries to mount some offense, but Malenko takes him down and again wraps up that leg. Both men tied up in the ropes now. Scorpio clutching that leg, and Malenko shoves him to the outside. And it seems the television title will not change hands tonight, as Scorpio retreats on one leg, on one good leg, from the shooter. The shooter's got hold of a chair, and if he smashes that chair to the ankle of Scorpio, this matchup is over. Scorpio kicking off Malenko. Great survival instincts by the challenger, who right now, you've got to believe, is not even thinking about the television title, but simply survival. Face first through the turnbuckle goes Scorpio. Scorpio whips it hard, here goes Malenko. Shoulder first into the turnbuckle goes Malenko. Scorpio scores with the forearm. Make it two. But he is still hobbling. He is in bad shape.
In 1995, the movie Batman Forever was released. Personally, I like to refer to that movie by its alternate title, Batman Until the Franchise Reboots When I'll Be Replaced by Christian Bale. But that's just me.
At this point, Malenko may not even be concerned with defending the TV title. He may just want to injure Too Cold Scorpio. Malenko going for a tombstone pile driver. No, Scorpio reverses the hold. And Scorpio's going to score with a tombstone. He hits. But instead of going for a cover, Scorpio trying to make his way to the top turnbuckle. He does. Moonsault hits. Cover, two, and no. Call it 2 7/8. Scorpio so close to pulling off the upset and winning the TV title, but he is in pain. And he hit hard, coming down from the top turnbuckle with the moonsault. Scorpio going up once again. And Malenko pulled referee Jim Malenko in the way, in harm's way, and Scorpio decks the ref. Jason is thrilled, and Malenko is back on the attack. And with no referee in sight, brainbuster. Scorpio brought down head first to the canvas, compressing his vertebrae. This matchup is over, and Malenko is going to hurt Scorpio. Just like he hurt Ron Simmons. Just like he. That's. Oh, I get the camera back on the outside. That's Taz in street clothes. Taz is in the ring. He's behind Malenko. Remember, it was Malenko who injured the knee, the massive leg of the Tasmaniac. Malenko has no idea what's behind him. And now the two come face to face. You could feel, you could smell the hatred in the air. Well, I guess Malenko is done with Scorpio. We've got a bonus matchup. The TV champion Malenko and his most persistent nemesis, Taz. Oh my God! Taz just suplexed Malenko on his head and folded him up like an accordion. Taz reviving the referee and lifting out of the ring. One, two, and no! The shooter somehow Where does he get it? He's made of iron. The Tasmaniac almost drove the shooter through the mat, and he was able to kick out the count of two. And Taz drops the shooter again straight down. Scorpio doesn't even want to accept help from Taz, because Taz helping you is liable to hurt you. Well, Taz has limped off. Malenko seems to be on Dream Street, and who wouldn't be? Scorpio now unloading on the shooter. He cinches up Malenko. Malenko goes behind. Rolls up Scorpio. Jason reminding the referee, one, two, no, Scorpio's up Malenko. Two and three, we have got a new television champion in Too Cold Scorpio. But the bigger story than Scorpio being a two-time television champion was the interference of Taz, a Taz we have never seen before. Well, Taz has gained a measure of revenge against the shooter. Wait a minute. We may have a problem here. It's no secret the triple threat. Not all too thrilled with Jason's involvement with the shooter. Oh, and this may be the end of it. Malenko angry, he is no longer the television champion. And he can thank Taz for that. As we get closer to the three-way dance, this situation gets hotter as every moment goes by.
Survive if I let you. Youch! I couldn't have coined a better phrase for the human suplex machine, Taz. And congrats to Too Cold Scorpio, by the way, even if he did get a little help. But I guess it's true what they say. You win some, you lose some, and you get screwed by Taz some.